Hi, welcome to my channel, the Machine Learning Engineer. Today continue with the series of videos I'm creating about the different use cases on LangChain. We are going to cover today document tagging. As usual, I create a notebook that later on I will post to the repository. And well, tagging, as the name says, is just create or evaluate a document versus a number of classes, put a label or different labels according to a topic, no, to a document. We can use this to evaluate the sentiment of the document, language, the style, and so on. It's a way to classify a document. I see it like that, and you can apply this with multiple perspectives to a single document. It had a direct use in multiple industries or companies, just extending, no, the metadata or the knowledge that we have about documents in our data lake, and this will give us the opportunity to understand better what we have in our data repositories. It can be as well databases or whatever. Wherever we have documents, we can apply these techniques just to understand or to extend the metadata that we have in our of our documents in the data lake. We already, or I already upload a video also about LangChain, LangChain extraction. It's another use case pretty similar, and especially pretty similar in terms of the tools on how we approach the problem. We will use here as well LangChain library together with PyDantit, one library that we use as well on the extraction use case. PyDantit is a library that which is widely used on Python and which is used to enforce the data types in Python, enforcing functions, methods, data classes, etc. Again, widely used as well to create APIs in Python, and also to control the data, the types of data in command line arguments, and again in APIs, or creating interfaces in between different components. So it's a way to just exactly define which data you had in and out. So here we use exactly the same to qualify and to perfectly, or as much as possible, perfectly define which type of data you want to tag, no, the document, and you get the constraints and values that you want to extract from that document. Okay, so let's start. You had as well in this is something that as in other use cases, we had already a class in LangChain predefined for this activity, for this tag, create tag in Chain, and you had a specific one if you want to use PyDantic classes. So here we will use as usual OpenAI model. So we import or we load to the environment variables the OpenAI key to pass the key once we create the OpenAI object to access the OpenAI model. So the easiest way to use the create tagging chain is to define an schema. Well, in fact, you have to define an schema which will tell the model what you want to, in which perspective you want to evaluate the document, the text, and also the format of the value that it will return. In this case, a string, aggressiveness is going to be an integer, and a language, the language mean the, yeah, the language of the document, also a string. You will see now that this approach had a small disadvantage. This is something that we also cover in the extraction, and then the, how to say, the we cover there the good practice, no, to follow when we are extracting information from using LLMs, using LangChain, and here you will see that applies exactly the same. No? So we define an schema, we want to evaluate the document versus sentiment, aggressiveness and language, and then on the you see that it's really simple to implement a chain to tag a document, and then you simply create a chat OpenAI object, temperature 0, not creativity here, no need, and also then you create the chain with the schema and the LLM. So you here we are evaluating some languages, and then on you will see here one of the examples I mentioned you before. So here you will see here that we wanted to evaluate the documents versus this, but yeah, we are giving the chance, as I mentioned in this in the guidelines of good practice of how to do extraction. Here, well, we give a lot of room to the LLM to return us and to do a few words whatever he please, no? Even when we had temperature 0. So we are not enforcing even here what we want to return to the what we want the model return as an answer, no? As a response. So that's why here it I make a guess here that it's not responding anything versus sentiment and aggressiveness because it's not finding a clear tag on the document to return you this. This is very probably will be obvious or more obvious when in some languages rather than in others, and also depending as well on the type of property that you want to against what you want to evaluate the test. So in this case, using this, the test is, yeah, in my opinion, I'm Spanish, I speak Spanish, and then I see that I think it can take at least the sentiment, but yeah, here. Yeah, here is more clear, probably because yeah, the text is quite evident, no, that is aggressive, no, and then it's able to extract the three tags of this document. Here we use it in German. It's also correct, and you see coherent with what we received on the in the previous query, and also button is angry in English, and yeah, the same level of the aggressiveness and the language is different. So what I say here is the LLM which is using their abilities to respond, but is giving you probably we evaluate this several times. Even with the same language, the same sentence, we are going to get to receive different answers. Here we try in Russian, and here, as you see here, already not returning angry. It's just returning a sentiment of negative, and it's probably because GPT 3.5 Turbo understand Russian. But it's not, probably it's not at the same level that other Latin derivative language like German, Spanish, English, or whatever, the Latin derivative language. So it's quite more complicated to understand the sentiment on a sentence in Russian, which you may know that Russian by default no, is quite a root language, and here is not an obvious, it's not a direct translation like you may see here from Spanish to German or also to English. I'm very angry at you. Sorry. Sorry, but here is not how to say, not such direct translation to Russian, and also here in the second sentence is also quite far from what we had either in Spanish or in German. Well, to avoid these effects, what we need to do is, as I explained you in this tutorial, good practice to use is just tell the LLM in the schema, in this case in extraction we did it with the prompt or with the Pydantic class, we tell the LLM exactly what we want and how it had to respond. So we are limiting or establishing boundaries in what the model can do and cannot do, and how we want or not want to receive an answer. Also, we can extend this, not here, but in extraction, we also include on the prompt, for example, don't lie, or if you don't know the answer, don't say, or say, I don't know, don't invent anything. No? So this is the way that we should interact in this kind of tasks with the LLM, and limiting and guiding the LLM via prompt or via schema or via Pydantic class how the model had to answer us or provide a response, because it's quite open, and then and models are quite capable, and then we just simply we don't get either some coherent answer or response, or even missing something. No, here in the schema we can include the require, so this will tell us I want you to answer me or provide me a tag versus any of these properties, and also here we are defining exactly what we want to receive. So even we pass a description, we can pass a description away to language and to sentiment. And then on you will see here now when we create the chain with this schema, you see here that the model is currently answering now or tagging the document versus the three required properties that we include on the schema. Take a look later on, make your own test in your own environment, and you can try with other documents, other language, other schemas, and you will see how the difference in between a schema like this and a detailed schema with the required attribute like this. So you want to do the same but with Pydantic, Pydantic library, so you can define a class that heritage from base model, and then on you can simply do exactly the same sentiment, aggressiveness and language, and you define via enumeration, so first of all the type, and secondly the type of the valid values that the model can use to evaluate the document versus that tag, and that's exactly that the model will. As you probably know, we will receive an object of the class tag, and then on inside this object you have the three in this case attributes that we get from this. To me, preferred option to use Pydantic and to use the class so to use the chain in this way. Again, this is quite conventional natural way, Pydantic way to to work in Python. So my advice, if you have the chance, do the tagging in this way. Now we had as well some integrations via document transformers. These are specific classes to work with a specific type of documents, and you can do the tagging after passing the document via one of these document transformers. No? We had the transformers to work with a beautiful sort. This library is usually used when you want to extract information from HTML, also XML. It's possible to work also XML documents and text and well, but mainly the main use is to work with HTML. You have here as well Google Docs, Google Translate, HTML to text, Nuclei, I don't know what this even, and OpenAI metadata tagger. This is the one we are going to use. But take a look if you are interested as well. I need to take a look to the rest because honestly I don't know Doctran or Nuclea, no idea, and also Voyage AI Ranker. I never worked with those. So if I don't know, I don't want to tell you a stupidity, because these tools, these technologies I didn't use before. So how we do it to replicate the example that we had about? You just import the create metadata tagger from the OpenAI metadata tagger, and we just create the same. Then similarly here, you see here we are specifying the properties and what is required to be returned on the from the model, no? As a part of the answer from the model. Here to work with these tools, as we are creating here a document, LangChain document, we will need to pass to the chain, we will need to create a we need to pass LangChain documents. And these LangChain documents can come from, well, loading text from Pandas data frame, for CSV, from a PDF, from HTML, from text, from a database, whatever. At the end, you need a LangChain document, which minimally had to contain page content attribute. If you don't specify any, see the metadata is going to be an empty dictionary, and here you may see that well, we create the metadata tagger here with our LLM and with the schema we have it here, and then we create some example of document, and then on using the transform document, this is exactly the same that we use after creating documents with a text loader or with a text splitter. We had LangChain documents, and we just pass the LangChain documents to an agent or like in this case to do some other, like here we will do some enhancement. In other cases we just pass the LangChain document to a vector store or to an agent for do another transformation. Here, what we are going to do here is just extend the metadata of these LangChain documents with the tags that we extract from the text included in page content. So you see here, once we do the apply the transform document to the original documents, we have the enhanced documents. And then on here we just print the metadata. You see here the first document doesn't contain metadata, and then we only extend the metadata with the tags that we specify on the schema. The second example, it contains metadata, it contains the attribute relabeled, so we include in the dictionary for the document the other tags, no? And similarly the third example. And the last cell, we just do the same but using Pydantic. identities, we define here the class properties that is again derivate from base model, and we apply exactly the same. Again, for me, preferably to use PyDantit, because again, Pythonic, Python style, and yeah, kind of for other developers that are going to read their code, it will be easier for them to use it that way, to use it this way. And that's all. I hope you like the content of the video. Very interesting, and again, it's a direct application to many use cases on a company, on a business, and then especially those that you want to well classify or understand the what the content had the documents that you had on the metala and your data lake, and this way you are able to first of all classify them correctly, or even establish a level or set up a level of risk of the documents that you have in your data lakes. Understanding what is inside, in versus, not only sentiment language, for example, you can classify versus different topics, or even you can set up this in base a level of risk according to the number of the NER detectives on your data lead. If you watch the video about extraction, we did something similar, detecting PII entities with the spacey, and then on according to the number and the risk that apply to these NER entities detected on the documents, we just classify the document in with a risk score. And this way we can apply corrected or protection measures to those folders, documents, whatever, or tag the document. For example, when you try to send or to attach the document to an email or whatever. No? It's again direct application of this tagging in many other activities, especially those connected with privacy and security in a company. And again, thank you for watching. I hope you enjoy and that you find the content interesting and useful. And as I said always, if you like the video, just give me a like and subscribe to the channel if you didn't do it before. Thank you very much.